אזרחי ישראל.
Citizens of Israel.
אני מקדיש
I am devoting my entire life in the security of Israel. I fought as a combatant in the Sayeret Mekkal
combatant unit.
I lost my older brother Yoni in a battle in the Suez Canal in the war of attrition. I almost lost my life.
מבצע לשחרור חטיפי מטוס סבנה.
I was fought in another operation.
סיכנתי את חיי.
I summarized my life once and one half time after another. In order to secure our lives here in the land of Israel.
כראש הממשלה.
As your prime minister.
הוריתי על ביצוע אינספור פעולות.
I directed the operation of many activities.
ובין המלחמות.
During war and between wars.
להבטיח את ביטחון ישראל.
In order to guarantee the security of Israel.
רובן עדיין עלומות.
Many of them are still unknown. At this opportunity, I want to show my gratitude to the fighters of the IDF, the brave fighters of the IDF, and the men of the General Security Service, the Mossad, and the police, who day after day are risking their lives for our security. On the issue of security, I made difficult decisions, many of them very difficult, and I take all responsibility. And when you take decisions like that, you worry about issues of life and death, issues that touch the existence of the state, the very existence of the state. And on these issues,
אין מקום לפוליטיקה.
There is no room for politics.
אין מקום לשיקולים אישיים.
There's no place for personal agendas.
רוב אזרחי ישראל יודעים.
Most of the citizens of Israel know that when I make
את ההחלטות בענייני הביטחון,
the decisions on issues of security,
אני עושה זאת בצורה עניינית.
I do this in a direct manner.
מתוך דאגה כנה.
Through a genuine concern.
דאגה כנה ועמוקה.
A genuine and deep concern.
לשלום מדינתנו.
For the peace of our state,
לביטחון אזרחנו,
for the security of our citizens,
לביטחון חיילנו,
and for the security of our soldiers.
אני לא אומר את זה מן השפה אל החוץ.
And I don't say this under pressure.
זה לא סיסמאות.
These are not slogans.
היום אני נכנס בפעם הראשונה.
Today I'm going for the first time to become this defense minister.
ואני יודע שאני עושה זאת.
And I know that I'm doing this.
בזמן שיש ביקורת.
At a time when there is criticism.
ביחס למדיניות הביטחון של ישראל.
On the security administration of Israel. I want to tell you, citizens of Israel, I understand what's in your hearts. A good deal of the criticism is from obvious reasons that I cannot show you. I can't show you the full things that are seen by the chief of staff, the heads of the General Security Service, the Mossad, and by me. I can't really reveal them. You only see a partial picture of a broader operation that we are still in the depths of. And I am committed to completing it for the security of our southern citizens and for the security of all of Israel. I won't say tonight when we will act and how we will act. I have a clear program. I know what to do. And when to do it. And we will do it. Citizens of Israel, not always are things clear at the exact moment. When I was a finance minister at the time of a difficult economic crisis, I knew what I had to do, and I did it. It was difficult.
ואתם זוכרים ששילמתי על כך מחיר פוליטי כבד.
And you remember that I paid a heavy political price.
אבל היום כולם מבינים.
But now everyone understands.
שהצלנו את כלכלת ישראל.
That we saved the economy of Israel.
והפכנו אותה לאחת הכלכלות החזקות בעולם.
And we made it one of the strongest economies in the world.
כשנכנסתי לתפקיד שר החוץ.
When I entered the position of foreign minister.
דיברו על בידוד מדיני.
They talked about diplomatic isolation.
על צונאמי מדיני שישטוף את מדינת ישראל.
A diplomatic tsunami that would overrun the state of Israel.
כאן ידעתי מה צריך לעשות.
Here too I knew what had to be done.
ועשיתי זאת.
I did it. Today, the foreign relations of the state of Israel are at the peak of all times. the peak of all times with the United States, that brought its embassy to Jerusalem, at a peak of all of the powers, with states in all continents, without any exceptions, including also countries in the Arab world. And that dangerous nuclear agreement with Iran, that was a fait accompli. Here too, I knew what had to be done. And I did it. I didn't hesitate for a moment. I went against the entire world. I went against the President of the United States. I had to go out against even those in Israel that like this horrible agreement that put our lives in danger. And then I brought about the cancellation of the agreement and the return of the sanctions on Iran. And that's what happened. Not everyone saw those things then. But now everyone sees those things today. And that will happen now also in the issues of security. We will fix for our enemies. I say this, my friends, not without diminishing the challenges in front of us. And I say from the start, this will be embodied with sacrifice, but I have no doubt that with our full strength of spirit and with the spirit of our soldiers and the strength of spirit of our citizens, we will bury our enemies. From my experience, I tell you that we sit at one of the difficult times in security ever. And in this period, you don't take down a government. In a time like this, you don't go to elections. It's irresponsible. We have another year until elections. We are at the height of the campaign, in the middle of the campaign, and we don't abandon it. In the middle of the campaign, you don't play political games. The security of the country is above politics. And the security of the country is also above political judgments. And therefore, you see the effort I'm making in the recent days. I'm making another effort to prevent unnecessary early elections. I spoke with the heads of all of the coalition parties. I told them, this is the time to show responsibility. Don't bring down the government. And especially, not in a sensitive security time like this. I told them not to make the mistake that was made in 1992 when government forces brought down a Likud government and then came on a government that brought about the Oslo disaster. I told them not to go back on the mistake that actors within the government did in 1999 when they brought down a Likud government and brought about a government that brought about upon us the Intifada with more than 1,000 dead. I hope that all the partners will show responsibility and will not bring down the government. I believe that you have to listen to them in behalf of the state of Israel and for the security of Israel. Thank you very much. I'm going to work.